Here is a modeling scenario that I think many of you would have come across. We have a cone here, and the intention is to build a protrusion at the top. The whole model is then shelled all the way through. This protrusion has a distinct shape looking from the side. So it would not be possible to do a sketch from the top and extrude down to the conical face using the tool object extent option. Take note also that we need the top face to be flat. In addition, the side walls need to be parallel to each other. So the revolve command is also out. I usually see this being done in the following ways. Some users would choose to start with a solid cone and simply draw a sketch profile that overlaps with the cone. For those who start with a shelled cone, some will do an overlap and delete the face or faces that protrude into the void. Others will try to adjust the protrusion to be within the thickness of the shelled cone. I often find these methods to be somewhat arbitrary, as they all model the design intent to a certain extent. Is there a way that we can stay true to the design intent by taking reference from the conical face? I'm going to propose the use of the rib command here. Admittedly, this is not a typical use of the feature. We are taking advantage of the extrapolative properties of the rib command, which is very useful in this scenario. We will start with the scenario where the designer chooses to shell the cone first. Let's start a sketch on the right plane. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersect. We will use this to create a reference line based off the conical face. When we hover over the conical face, we see a preview of two red lines. These lines are a result of the intersection between the sketch plane and the conical face. Select the conical face and confirm. Proceed to draw the profile of the protrusion. Go to Create, Rib. Select this chain of three edges. Set thickness options to symmetric. Set depth as up to next. As we drag the arrow, notice how the feature extrapolates to hug the conical face. If the feature doesn't look right, you might have to flip the direction. With this, we do not need to worry about gaps forming between the extrude and the conical face. We also do not need to worry about the extrude exceeding into the void. Go to Modify, Shell. Let's first select this face and adjust the shell thickness to be the same as the cone. You can see that the shell does not go all the way through to the cone. If your design intent is not to shell through, you can leave it at that. In order to shell through, proceed to add this face by control selecting it. Let's repeat the same process starting with a solid cone. Again, we will create the same sketch. The rib creation process is also the same. When it comes to shelling, in order to shell all the way through to the protrusion, you will proceed to select these faces. If you do not wish for the shell to propagate through to the protrusion, this is more tricky compared to the previous scenario. In this case, there isn't actually a combination of faces that we can select that will produce this result. To stop the shell from propagating into the protrusion, we would have to split out the protrusion into a separate body. Let's delete the shell. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the body to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select this conical face. With that, we can shell the cone without affecting the protrusion. Begin a separate shell command for the protrusion. We would have to select these faces. Lastly, combine the two bodies.